727 on your Saturday morning. We have the latest information on Hurricane Isaias. This is as the 5 o'clock advisory, or as of the 5 o'clock advisory, I should say, and it's strengthened overnight. If you're just now joining us, that's the big change. Winds have gone from 80 up to 85 miles an hour and it's moving to the northwest at 12. So it's slowed down its forward speed very slightly as well, but it's still moving to the northwest, still going to make its approach to the east coast of Florida. But one of the big changes you will notice, especially for us here in Southwest Florida with this forecast cone this morning, as well, it is expected to make that approach to the east coast of Florida by early tomorrow morning. We are once again out of the forecast cone. That includes a majority of Lake Okeechobee. But that being said, if this hurricane does take this western track, we could have more gusty conditions closer to Lake Okeechobee, and I'll show you a forecast for that here in just a moment. Once it approaches the east coast, potentially making landfall depending on just how far west it does eventually travel, it will continue to travel up the southeast coast and eventually, at least potentially, make another landfall somewhere around South Carolina to North Carolina. So some warnings and watches out ahead of this hurricane, including a tropical storm warning for Lake Okeechobee, but not for the communities surrounding Lake Okeechobee. It's just for the lake itself, as the worst of this storm, as the worst of this hurricane is still expected to stay just offshore. But of course, we will still have some gusty conditions closer to Lake Okeechobee as well as on the east coast. So here's what we're expecting in terms of rainfall through Tuesday morning. We could have anywhere from a quarter to more than an inch of rain, depending on how those outer rain bands continue to roll in. And when it comes to our windy conditions, we do expect again the breezier conditions closer to Lake Okeechobee, around 25 to 30 miles an hour by lunchtime close to the lake, while Clewiston, LaBelle, and up through Buckhead Bridge will have wind gusts up to around 35 miles an hour through the remainder of the evening. So not tropical storm strength, but definitely gusty, and we will continue to pay very close attention to that as it continues to move away. For the remainder of the day, we do expect at least a few scattered showers and thunderstorms, but for now, we'll leave you with sunny skies. Brand new update on this hurricane coming at 8 o'clock.